everyone, today I'm doing another empties video. I know I just did one of these recently, but I can't believe I already filled up my basket I have here. So I want to throw this stuff away, so I thought I would just do one of these. You guys seem to really enjoy them, which is surprising because it seems like it'd be boring talking about my trash, but you guys seem to like it. So definitely let me know if you want me to continue doing these, because I definitely will. I will have the playlist linked down below if you want to see my other ones, because you get to see a lot of my all-time favorite products and some things that didn't work out for me. So let's go ahead and get started. First thing I always have in here is makeup remover wipes. These are my favorite. I'm going to keep repurchasing these. Highly recommend them. This is a simple micellar makeup remover wipe. So the other sensitive ones are just like cleansing wipes, but these are actually made to remove makeup. And I'm pretty sure they have a new like cleansing oil too that I've heard people talk about. So love these so much. I can always get a coupon for them too, like at Target or CVS and stuff. So I end up buying like 2 or 3 packs. More skincare here. I have the Michael Todd Charcoal Detox Deep Pore Gel Cleanser. This is one of my all-time favorite skincare products as well, because it just works so good. I always use this in the morning. Sometimes I use it with my Sonoclear cleansing brush too. I do have a discount where you can get 20% off Michael Todd if you order through my link, so I will have that down below. But this just helps to unclog my pores. It makes such a difference because I have trouble with clogged pores and I don't notice them as much when I do use this. I've been using it for so long. I love it so much. I found out my boyfriend was using that in the shower too, and I told him to stop because I didn't want him to use it up, but he really liked it and he had been using it for weeks, and I was like, where did it all go? And now it's in my empties, so maybe I should get one for him. Here's another cleanser that I have, the Aveeno Clear Complexion Foaming Cleanser. This is what I typically use with my Sonoclear just because it foams up really good. This has salicylic acid treatment in it, so it helps prevent breakouts and keep your skin clear. I don't know if it does all that, but it works well at removing the rest of my makeup, and it works good with the cleansing brush. It says it's non-comedogenic and hypoallergenic and soap-free, so it's really gentle. I highly recommend this just as a basic cleanser for everyone. It's not as nourishing, though, as the Michael Todd one, that's for sure. Oh, it looks like I have another one of these in here, so I obviously really like them. I think I bought 2 at the time. One more skincare product I see, this is the L'Oreal Collagen Moisture Filler. This is actually the night cream that I used. I scraped the bones of this because I love it a lot. This is my favorite night cream that I've ever tried. It just smells amazing. It's the right thickness for me and it just makes my skin look so plump. After I use my Sonoclear, which helps like cleanse everything and just make it more plump, I guess, this just helps. What am I even saying? Plump skin? I don't have plump skin, but you know what I mean. It just looks very supple, I guess is the right word. So I highly recommend this. I can usually find coupons for this or order it on Amazon where it's a lot cheaper. So I'll be sure to link it for y'all. Oh, one more skincare item. This is the Polish Choice Resist Youth Extending Daily Mattifying Fluid. This is an SPF 50, which is awesome for the summertime. I really love this daytime moisturizer. I use it every single day. It's great for the summertime because it's very thin. It's a really thin liquid fluid. So it just works really good because it's going to help protect your skin from the sun, and it's also great to use under makeup. So this is made for like combination or oily skin, but anyone can use it no matter what skin type you have. But I highly recommend it for people who tend to get kind of oily and stuff under their makeup. I do have a discount code, I think, for that too. It might have expired. If not, I'll find it cheaper for you guys somewhere. Now for some hair products, I have the Aveda Dry Remedy Moisturizing Mask. So sad that I use this up because I love it so much. This is my favorite deep conditioner that I've tried. It's so hydrating and works really well. It has lots of good ingredients in it. Aveda is all natural, one of my favorite hair care companies, and I use it probably about once a week. My other favorite hair care company is Living Proof. This is the Curl Defining Styling Cream. This is my all-time favorite hair product that I use. It's the only thing that does not make my hair frizzy. Like, I need to get another one of these. I've been using up some other ones that I have and they just are not cutting it for summertime. I apply them and then within an hour or two of going outside, my hair looks like a frizz bomb. So this is the only thing that keeps it from looking frizzy. When I combine this with their mousse that they have in their curl line, it's like the perfect combination. But I'm really trying to declutter and use up some of the products that I have, whether it be makeup or hair care, skincare. So I'm not going to purchase it until I finish up my others, but it's killing me because I can't stand how my hair looks some days. You guys always say it doesn't look frizzy, but you can't see it on the camera. It doesn't show up. Then I have another deep conditioner that was in my shower for like 30 years. This is the Aussie Moist 3-Minute Miracle Deep Conditioning Treatment. I used to talk about this all the time in my videos. It's a great drugstore deep conditioner. I recommend it to a lot of people who don't want to purchase higher end stuff. This does have silicone in it, so if you use like all natural hair care products or if you are sulfate free, then you have to be a little bit careful that you don't apply this too much because it could weigh down your hair, but I never have that trouble with this, so I've been using this a while. I had like a tiny bit left, and so I finally finished it because I wanted to throw it in this video. So there's always a shaving cream in here too. This is the Gillette Satin Care for Sensitive Skin Shave Gel with Aloe Vera. This works really great because it doesn't dry out my legs or anything, and it's made for sensitive skin. It's really sad when there's a fake bake in here because I go through these like crazy. This is the Fake Bake Flawless Darker Self-Tanning Liquid. I rave about this. I've been using it for years. My all-time favorite self-tanner. I'm pretty sure there's going to be one of these in every empties video from here on out because I can't stop using it. I'm like addicted. So I apply this once a week and I do about 2 coats at least of this. So I get really dark with it. I have the very first review I did where I had like before and afters. I'll link that for you guys down below, but I need to do an updated video with this. Then I have the Healthy Deodorant by La Vanilla. This is the Fresh Vanilla Lemon Scent. This is one of my favorite scents that they have. This is an all-natural, aluminum-free deodorant. This is the only scent that works the best on me. I recently repurchased this on Amazon, and I actually got the Sport version, which is a new one that they just came out with. I really love the scent of it because it doesn't have a drop of vanilla in it. I can't stand vanilla scents, so it's crazy I even use this brand, but it works really well for me. But the Sport version is definitely more long-wearing, and I don't have to reapply it throughout the day. It's great for the summertime, but I do recommend the lemon version as well. So if you're going to pick one, either go with the Sport or the lemon vanilla one. I don't smell really vanilla in this. It just smells very lemony and fresh, so yeah, I used all of that up. It lasts me a really long time. I feel like one of these lasts me like 6 months to a year, so I don't have to buy them that much. Last but not least, I have some makeup. This is the CoverGirl Outlast Stay Fabulous 3-in-1 Foundation. I go through these a lot too. I recently picked up a darker one and a really light one. That way I can mix them when I'm self-tanning to get the perfect shade, but this is in Classic Ivory. This is like my middle ground shade to where I could get away with this either way, but I recently got a dark one and a lighter one. This has SPF 20, really long wearing. This has a primer and a concealer and powder mixed into it, so it does dry pretty matte. It's really full coverage too, so you can either sheer it out really thin or you can apply it in layers like I always do to get a fuller coverage. I use that in all my videos. I need to switch it up for you guys to review more stuff, but I can't help it. I just really like it. Same for this. This is the e.l.f. Perfect Finish HD Powder. I used up all of this. This is my favorite face powder. Packaging on it is a little wobbly, but my new one's just fine that I got. You can get this at the drugstore. It's like $3. Best face powder I've ever tried. It's the only one that actually keeps my eyeliner and mascara from smudging because I don't always wear eyeshadow like today. And if I don't have a powder around my eyes, I always get like little dots around my eyes from my mascara. Really annoying. This is the only thing that keeps everything from creasing and smudging. Keeps me matte all day long. 2 NYX eyebrow products. These are also always in these videos. This one has duct tape on it because my packaging broke. But this is the NYX Control Freak Eyebrow Gel. I need to repurchase this. I've been using another eyebrow gel and it just doesn't cut it. This is my favorite. It holds up the entire day. It's clear, really cheap. I'm definitely going to be repurchasing that. Then I have the NYX Micro Brow Pencil. I've already repurchased this. This is in chocolate. I feel like I might need a darker shade though. But it's like a warm brown color. But it's nice because it's super fine. Like it's awesome. This is identical to the Anastasia Brow Wiz. But it's like a quarter of the price and you can get it at the drugstore. Whoa, I talked way too fast, but that's all the empties that I had for today. I'll be sure to link you guys to where you can get all of these as cheap as possible, especially on Amazon. Definitely check out that blog post. It'll be the first link down below where you can get all the products that you want. There's still a small bit of time left for you to enter my giveaway where I'm giving away a Beauty for Real blush and glow stick. That link will be down below as well. And I just filmed a video all about how I self-tan my face to match the rest of my body. So I'll have that link down below if you're interested. Don't forget to tell me in the comments too what products you're recently loving and what you've used up recently. I would love to know. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll talk to you in my next video. Bye everyone. Hey everybody, today's video is going to be all about how to self-tan your face at home. I personally love using self-tanner. My all-time favorite is the Fake Bake Flawless Darker. I've been using that